His Imperial Highness,
well,
Crown Prince of Japan.
Imperial Highness, it is a great honor to welcome you to our country and to Washington.
Thank you very much. Kind of invitation.
Well, please have that.
Ambassador of Japan, Ambassador Okawara, who was Ambassador
here before. Nice to see you. Nice to see you. And Mr.
Yasujima.
How do you do?
And
my
husband.
Well,
and Ambassador Mansfield.
Nice to see you there. Your Imperial Highness, I think you're due to
this way.
Just to let them have a few photographs and so forth, and then we'll be back in here for a few minutes. That it's shortened your visit here. You have to return early. And you're here in the United States. We welcome you. And we're pleased to have
you.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. Before I departed Japan, I met my father, the Emperor, and he sends you the best regards.
Oh, well, please return mine to him. We remember with great pleasure the warmth and the hospitality that he extended to us when we were there.
I was certain to do that when I returned to Japan.
Our first meeting was long before I was president, but I was there as governor of California and had been sent to represent the president.
Hi, Mr. President.
Hi, how are you?
It's certainly nice to see you again.
Yeah, good to see you.
Pleasure, thank you. You look excellent as usual.
Well, I feel good.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Take the chairs there.
Thank you. I have already seen your good friend and...
That's just been warmed up by a crown prince.
Well, I mean, I'll try to act appropriately.
He's the crown prince of Cook County.
Actually, I'm not from Cook County, Howard. Did you know that?
Yeah, I did know that.
I'm from Belleville.
You also told me that you were the third best tennis player on your block.
You must have had relatives in my hometown, Dixon.
You know, the funny thing, the Dixons are all very dear friends. And Sherwood Dixon was lieutenant governor of Illinois when I was a freshman in the Illinois House.
Well,
he was lieutenant governor under Adlai Stevenson.
Yeah.
And that whole family have been very dear friends of mine.
Sure.
But I'm not
well,
sure that those
well.
Dixons are relations.
Yeah. Well, a Dixon. They were all descended from Father Dixon. They called him Father Dixon. He wasn't a priest. He had the ferry across the river there, and that grew into a town.
Yeah. Judge Mike Kinney from Madison.
Pretty good. Good to see you. I think you know that.
Yes, sir.
Lawton gets more distinguished for the day.
Okay.
It's all warm from the last crown prince of Japan.
He's an interesting fellow, Mr. President.
Yes, he is.
He seemed to be genuinely interested in the conversation.
As I figured out, he's about 59 years old. And I kept thinking of him the first time I saw him some years ago there at the palace.
Well, I remember some pictures of him when he was a young fellow.
When he was a kid.
I don't remember seeing any pictures of him later or here.
Wait a minute, I said 59, 57, I'm sorry, 57. But about him, this is the oldest royal family in the world. When he becomes the emperor, he will be the 125th emperor of that family to be emperor.
125th.
Isn't that something?
It's a pretty good line.
Yeah. Well, listen, you know what I want to talk to you about. I just would like to.
How are you? Bob Graham from Florida.
Yes, I know.
Glad to see you.
Good to see you.
Good.
Right?
Yeah,
that's right. Let's chair over there. Of course, I know you're just puzzled as to why I wanted to see you.
Well, I was telling Mr. Baker that I think I knew what to talk about. I'd also like to chat a bit about the speech that I think I'm going to give tomorrow to the OAS on the Central American Peace Corps.
All right. But you want to go first?
Well, it's your agenda, so why don't we do your subject first?
Well, you know what I want in that, and I know you understand appointing judges because you appointed 300 of them.
Yes.
When you were governor.
And we didn't have the Senate confirmation. In California, did the Senate confirm judicial?
No, I just did. But I had followed someone who had kind of politicized the whole appointment process, and I made up my mind and made a declaration that I would take the appointment of them out of politics. So I set up a whole setup of groups, like the legal profession in the district where the candidate was, and a panel of judges, and then finally the governors, or the states, bar association, the board of governors. And none of them knew about each other. And I would get a rating from all of them, and then our people would put them down on a scorecard here, which group it was and what was the rating. And the rating was from not qualified up through qualified to well qualified to excellent qualified. And I went by that score in appointing them. Sometimes there would be some that would be virtually tied. Well, then I could have the leeway to say, well, if taking an ethnic thing or whether maybe.
Thank you. President, Mr. Nikonov, member of the Politburo of the Central Committee.
How are you? This is my chief of staff, Senator Baker.
Senator Baker.
How are you, sir? Welcome.
Yes, sir.
We'll have to just sort of small talk for a few moments. They're going to try to shout questions at me about a domestic matter, and I'm going to try to shut them up.
Are the interpreters in the picture?
Yes.
And I'm very grateful for giving me this opportunity.
The prestigious
I understand full well that for normal mortals, it's not an everyday affair. So I'm
Today, or has he met with you?
Kevin, I've not changed my position, but I'm not going to take any questions either.
You've not changed your position, but has he changed his?
I can't take any questions.
Would you accept his withdrawal, Mr. President?
If I start answering, I've broken my word.
Should we expect an announcement today?
No way of knowing.
Are you going to meet with this?
This way, please. Thank you.
Mr. Nikonov,
do you have a message of Mr. Gorbachev?
У вас есть послание
господина Горбачева? Я передам сейчас послание, которое Михаил Сергеевич просил меня передать.
I shall transmit to the president message that Mr. Gorbachev wanted to transmit. It is a very positive in content.
About the summit?
Это о встрече на высшем уровне.
Да, это тема не только журналистов. Волнует она волнует весь мир.
That subject is not only of concern to pressmen, it is of concern to the entire world.
Thank you. Let's go, please.
That is their profession. They cannot do otherwise to give those questions.
Господин президент, позвольте мне передать вам от Михаила Сергеевича, вам и вашей супруге, госпоже Нансенеры, самые теплые пожелания доброго здоровья. успешной деятельности на благо американского народа.
Я
благодарю.
May I, on behalf of General Secretary Gorbachev, convey to you the best wishes to you and Mrs. Reagan, and also to convey to you his wishes for success in your activities for the benefit and in the interest of the American people.
Hello, how are you?
Hey, how are you? Nice to see you. See you with you.
Yeah?
Thank you. See, Howard Henry's here. Yeah, very good.
Over here, Ted. I just kicked the Russian Politburo fellow out of there.
Is that right?
Well, it's all warmed up for him.
He's still warm.
I noticed your governor up there wants to start commuter traffic between Russia and Alaska.
Oh, we used to have it.
Is that right?
Yeah, in the Ford administration we had.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, it was a really popular thing. It flew from Nome over to Khabarovsk and to Leningrad, then Moscow, and then back to Khabarovsk and into Nome again. It was a great trip. Yeah. Didn't ever get to take it myself.
Well, I wanted to talk to you about our Dreyfus case here.
Our Dreyfus case?
Say that I'm teed off is an understatement of the year, but I think a hell of an injustice is being done